Dakota and I have known each other for a long time. We've been filming together for years, and I actually helped him film his souvenir part for a foundation a couple years ago. And at that same time is when I met John Dickson. I wasn't even working for Emerica at the time. It was more of just skating as friends and just doing what kind of felt natural in a way. Eventually I ended up getting a job at Emerica, and John's shoe was coming out a year later. So we had to start to figure out what we wanted to do. Meanwhile, we were still filming me, Dakota, and John every day together, and Dakota really wanted to get on Emerica. So over time, he started stacking up a lot of footage, getting interviews in Thrasher, just killing it really all over. And it came time to put him on the team. And we're all really glad to have him. So we were all just filming together as friends, and that turned into a full Emerica video. Every morning I get a text from John, 7 a.m. saying, "Morn, I'll go pick him up, and then I'll go to Leo's house and pick up him in Dakota." You've got John in shotgun, always DJ, playing rock. And then behind me, you've got Dakota.
Working with Dickson is like epic because it's just working with a friend, really. It's pretty insane watching him skate. You know, he's so good at skating. That's why it's so wild. You're watching someone that's like, they can't do anything bad. And that's so rare to see, you know, like it kind of makes you like want to try and be better, you know? Being able to share a video with John is really epic to me and like a milestone for my life, because I've always been such a big fan of John, and like I've known John for a really long time, so being here now is really special and I'm super stoked. And I hope John feels the same, because fuck, he's badass.
It was nice filming a video with Dakota, because I've known him for a long time and we just mesh well, and like we just feed off each other when we're out skating, I guess, you know? Dakota's approach to skating spots is pretty intense. He just tries really hard for the tricks he wants to get. Won't stop till he gets them. Either he's gonna make it or he's gonna get really smoked. Just how he is. Just 100% all the time. We're in the last few weeks of filming for the video, and Dakota's been battling this trick. We've been going back quite a few times for him to get it. So he's just been kind of losing his mind about that. Deadlines are always, it's crunch time, you know? So everyone's kind of going crazy. Everyone's got their own way of going about getting it done, you know what I mean? And yeah, this one's just been haunting him, so he's been going crazy a little bit.
Figure it out. That's all you can really do.
It's a damn paradise. Number 4 today. Okay, we'll get it. Give me number 5.
Trying to get this last thing has just been like kind of like a living hell, but you work so hard on this whole entire film, you know? And then now at the end, like Tim works so hard and has all this footage, and now Miner's putting all the pieces together to make it the Emerica film that we all wanted in the beginning. Just you have to stay driven with stuff, you know?
I came into this project on the tail end of it. They were right at their filming deadline, and so it's been a very quick turnaround. The process of that has been really cool, because we've all been working together, and they've been coming over almost daily and just seeing like the progress, and we just go back and forth and we talk about the music and the edit, and everything is like, it's all a collaborative. It's not even work when it's like that, it's just fun. I consider those two guys like two of my closest friends. It's like we're mostly just hanging out and laughing, and then those guys, they rip.
Hi. Rock.
John's rock.
Just another round.
Another round, let's go.
Jump in, let's go.
Yeah, it's been exhilarating, to say the least, watching Dakota battle for this trip. Like I said before, like, he just doesn't stop until he can't skate anymore.
The places that your head will go when you're working on something like this, or anything that's like important to you, it's not even just skateboarding, it could be anything for any kind of person. Oh, it was gnar in my head.
I'm stoked.
You don't know that you can go in those dark places, but you can. There's always a little bit of light though, you gotta search for it. And that was a staple in my life. I'll always remember that day. Everything just like washed over my body, just like, what the fuck? Like,
it's over.
It's done, like I'm done with this part.
I need cigarettes, and I need that clip on John's computer so I can be like, okay.
To finally like see it all done, it was just like the weight like off your shoulders, you know? You're just like, okay, now I've done everything I know that I can do physically for this video part, and like seeing it put together and how Miner did it, it was just like, okay, we're done.
That works, right?
Works right for me.
There you go.
Yeah, the Miner. Yeah. That's how the magic happens right there.
Moving on.
Moving on. A handshake. Or a hug. Very good.